congratulations.
Thank
first
you.
And foremost, I loved it. It was visually just stunning, and I can't believe, like, looking at the story behind it, that it was going to be a whole different film. Mm-hmm. And then in 12 weeks, you just created something completely new.
Yeah.
You must have been quite stressed out by that process.
I felt liberated. I felt like slightly like a madman.
Yeah.
Who was kind of like liberated from the confines of rational thought.
Is that a good thing for a director?
Maybe. I don't know.
You had to call up your cast and explain.
Yeah.
Because I mean, speaking to Jude and speaking to the other guys, that they were really, really receptive to the new idea. Was that an easy conversation for you in all those cases?
Yeah, it was quite. Because the point was to really focus on the characters and the performances. Mm. To try and shed the kind of preconceived ideas of presentation within the naturalistic form, and do something that was more concentrated, really.
I think that's why I really loved it so much. It felt like more like where theatre and cinema meet than any film I've seen for such a long time. In that sense, and you kind of exaggerate that with some of the transitions, some of the audio effects as well.
And
for instance, there's a bit where Karenin shreds the paper, I think, and it becomes snow.
And it's also what I find really interesting is the in terms of the use of sound. You know, there's a scene, for instance, near the beginning where we're in the theatre space and Kira walks through, and then a set is constructed around the characters. And as the set is constructed around the characters of a kind of an office in a city, and therefore we bring up the sound of the city outside. And quite quickly, that oral reality feeds into a place where we believe that we forget that what we've just come from. You know, I think it's an interesting experiment for me in terms of audience perception.
Yeah, yeah.
And imagination.
Yes, and moustaches.
And an experiment in the moustachio.
The darker realms of moustaches.
Yes,
and I gather you grew a sympathy moustache.
Yes.
Well, I know, because I've seen
which
pictures of it.
Which I was quite proud of.
And it's gone. You think you'd maybe keep that for just day to day?
No. I liked it.
Yeah.
But I was just beginning to feel a bit like a fat old moustachioed man.
And yours isn't as twiddly as Aaron's one. He's got very,
Aaron's got a very fine, handsome, twiddly one.
He thought his would be quite hip in Hoxton.
Yeah, his would have been, Yeah, Matthew's is the proper meaty kind of, you know, walrus moustache.
Yeah.
Very extraordinary girth to his moustache.
Did you know when you cast him that he could grow that kind of moustache?
I had a feeling.
You really did have a feeling about his face?
I thought he could probably grow.
You had a feeling or you actually kind of just...
No, I didn't actually touch his face. I mean, I kind of had a feeling that he had that in him. He could grow a proper moustache.
Yeah, he's got that look about him.
He's got the chest for it.
You're doing theatre, you mentioned, I've got to wrap up shortly, but very quickly, you're doing theatre. Can you give us an idea of what potentially, because the films you've done, The Soloist, Hannah, they've all been so different in the last few films, and prior to that, obviously, Atonement. What next? What you want to do next?
In terms of film?
Yeah.
I've no idea.
What would you like to do? Do you have an urge?
I'd quite like to do another action movie.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah.
I really don't know, to be honest with you. I kind of, you know... your career is what happens whilst you're developing other scripts. And you know, I'm... In a way, this is the first film that I ever really knew that I was going to make a long way in advance.
Yeah.
Things happen, who knows?